Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are on our wonderful planet this Monday. It's June here in California, Southern California. We just have the most gorgeous weather. We're so grateful. For those of you tuning in for the first time, you're about to listen to the power and wisdom of Dao De Jing through Dao Calligraphy and Dao Song with Dr. and Master Shigong Sha. Dr. and Master Shigong Sha is the world's leading authority on Lao Zi. For me, it's as if he's the reincarnation of Lao Zi. I am a scholar as well as a literary agent. I went to Harvard and Yale, studied philosophy, and I studied a lot of different philosophers. And I have to say that any true philosophy has been influenced, whether consciously or not, by the thinking and writings of Lao Zi. He lived 2,600 years ago. He was sought after by the royals in China at that time as a counselor for his wisdom. I don't really know how he was able to do this, but there's no question in my mind that he somehow had access to the Tao. This course is all about the Tao. And what's unique about this over any purely intellectual course about Dao De Jing is that Dr. Master Sha also has the ability to connect with the Tao. The Tao cannot be seen, cannot be heard. It's the source of the known world, the world of things, as well as the invisible world, the world of nothingness. But Tao is not the world of nothingness. Tao is the creation a priori before the creation of the yin and yang worlds and even of the nothingness world. And we've already learned, and I always tell people, go back, study chapter one. Today, we're going to enter chapter 12. And this is a very profound chapter. The essence of the chapter is the biggest enemy in life is yourself. Other clients that I've represented, people who don't know me, I'm also a very prominent literary agent. I represent people like Neil Donald Walsh, Eckhart Tolle, Marianne Williamson, Deepak Chopra. And I also created, our company created the Four Dummies series. So I've been around the block, as they say, and I've been exposed to a lot of powerful speakers and thinkers. And when I read this chapter, I was immediately thinking of Eckhart Tolle, because Eckhart Tolle talks about how the ego, which is really a reflection of the pain body, is the biggest enemy towards preventing us from living enlightened lives. And to see this reflected in the writings of Lao Zi 2,600 years ago really caught my attention. Dr. Master Sha, for those of you coming in for the first time, is a grand master of ancient Chinese arts, Qigong, acupuncture, herbal medicine. He's also been trained as a medical doctor. That's why we call him Dr. Sha. He is one of the most generous human beings I've ever met. He provides this hour-long course on the Dao De Jing every Monday on Facebook. There's no charge of any kind. The reason he does this and the reason I participate as well is we really believe that the planet is facing a crisis and the human species is facing a crisis at this time. And the best way to deal with a crisis is to become aware of how each of us as individuals participate in either creating this crisis or de-escalating this crisis. Because ultimately, each and every human being has an equal responsibility. Some of us may be in positions of power, and from the outside, it may look like, oh, well, that person, they can just, you know, pick up the phone and change the course of history. Well, all of us actually can change the course of history. It's more subtle, and it doesn't necessarily happen overnight. But by raising our own awareness, by becoming more attuned to the principles of the Tao, we will be happier and healthier ourselves. And the happier and healthier we are, the happier and healthier we can make others around us. And the happier and healthier those around us are, the more they can contribute to our larger communities and to the world community. So this is about personal knowledge and wisdom, mostly wisdom. You'll learn in this course the difference between knowledge and wisdom. Wisdom is eternal, like the Tao. It exists forever. Knowledge is ephemeral. Anything that you can actually name is ephemeral. The Tao exists beyond our comprehension. It's more than a billion years. It's more than a trillion years. It's more than eons. It's immeasurable. And we actually are part of the Tao. We actually participate in this eternal existence. And the more we can become aware of how we do this consciously, rather than just as sort of these mini personalities with these bodies that we have for, you know, in most cases, it's going to be 100 years or less, the more we can truly enjoy the 100 years we may have in these bodies, but more importantly, perhaps, contribute to the larger evolution of intelligence and life on our planet. So, you know, there's a lot that you're going to learn today. I encourage everyone, I think all of these shows have been archived. I encourage everyone, if this is your first time, as soon as this show ends, go back, play the recording of chapter one. For me, chapter one is the essence of the entire Dao De Jing, because it explains the difference between the world of things, the you world, and the wu world, the world of nothingness. And the concepts that are presented are really very simple, but they're also very complex. And I will also share that I don't necessarily agree 100% with everything Lao Zi says, because Lao Zi did live 2,600 years ago. He's going to write today in chapter 12, he writes about some things that really were specific to his time, hunting and horse racing and how these, but they're symbols. When you encounter this information, you need to look at it in the context of his time and what that symbolized for him and the people that he was addressing directly. And then what does it really mean for us? Obviously, horse racing is, you know, no different than football or baseball or any of our other sports. It's a distraction. It's something that you can get excited about. And you need to have that balanced the same way. I think hunting is different. I mean, I personally am not a hunter, but I respect the people that were brought up. I mean, if you're brought up in a hunting environment, you know, that's something that's going to be part of your life. And as we've learned in other chapters, the Tao itself doesn't judge. You know, you're a hunter, you're not a hunter, you're a vegetarian, you're not a vegetarian. The Tao really is very neutral about all this. It's not telling you exactly what to do or what not to do. But in this chapter, it is definitely giving you some direction. It's always about being humble, about not seeking to impress others, not seeking ephemeral fame, wealth. It's not really that important. But better you hear it from Lao Zi and from Dr. and Master Sha. So let me present to you Dr. and Master Sha.
Welcome all. Thank you, Bill. Bill has a great wisdom. I respect Bill from my heart and soul. His background, the PhD degree in a famous university, and also one of the and the top book agent with all kinds of renowned speaker teachers. Thank you, Bill, for your great contribution for supporting my service teaching. I'll put it back. Chapter 12, Du Wai Yang Zhong. Bill has given some essence. Du means stop. Wai, external. Everybody say external, everything in your life, society, now in the world, COVID-19, war, all kinds of issues. That's called external distractions. Are we gonna affect it? Every day we have, you know, media, you know, internet. That's external distraction, disturbance. Then yang zhong, yang means nourish. Zhong is internally. There's a lot of detail. Lao Zi's wisdom, like also Bill emphasized, wisdom lasts forever. Knowledge is only for decades because knowledge has developed so fast. So Lao Zi's Dao De Jing, one sentence, each phrase is giving the deep meaning. There's a literary meaning, there's a deep meaning. So therefore, we try to go to deeper. 无色令人目盲. 无色, see here, 无色, is five colors. I didn't put it here since Alan. 青赤黄白黑. It's like this. 无色, 无色, I can write it here. 青, 青 is a green. Green. 赤, 赤 is red. That is a basic color. 青赤黄, 黄, 黄 means yellow. Yellow. 白, by, here, this color, white, this is white, it's not clear, you know, white, hei, it's a basic color, hei is black. Okay, go back again. So, 青赤黄白黑, a basic color. So, Lao Zi said, five color, 令人 can make. Mu is our eye. Mang means blind. People say, really? How can I understand? I see color every day. My eyes are not blind. See, that's just superficially try to understand a lot of meaning. See my teaching here. 无色令人目盲 means is it is the that eyes are dazzled. Alan, dazzled. Some English words. I prepare. Thank you, Alan. Alan is my one of my grandmaster teachers. My final editor for my more than 20 books. I studied 1 year English before I leave China. That's why you know, we saw that Alan is hard to offer Dao De Jing teachings. Sometimes, you know, he's beside me a dazzled. You know that how wise and prescient, how wise, I know the meaning, these words I do not use often. How wise and prescient was Lao Zi that 2,500 years ago about. He could see our modern world today. he saw that we live as though we are in the theater with all kinds of light shining in our eyes to dazzle. Bedazzle us. So that would disturb bothers. Everybody know the big theater. You know that. In the spiritual journey, talk about the changing. Everybody, this from this point, we think about it. So as our life, everybody think our life. Everything happens every day. Are you have a peaceful heart? Are you bothered by ABCD? You know how busy Bill. Bill also share with me many things. Do you have the changing heart? Lao Zi said because it's kind of color, boom, 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 bothers us, huala, huala, huala. We need internal. Remember the title of the chapter is do what. and stop this kind of disturbance, color, all the issues. Then quietness. That's a deep meaning. This is, in fact, it's not a color make your eye blind, but the literal meaning is blind. But the deep meaning is all kinds of disturbance. Use this kind of light. It bothers. It's dazzled our eyes. That is a 无色令人目盲. Wu yin ling ren er long. You know, the sound, guang de guang, not only color, the sound in the theater, and also five notes can make our ear deaf. That's people, wow, it's so serious every day with this music. I love the music. This talk about this bothered music. Everybody know the music, some music, oh, you cannot handle. That's exactly talk about that kind of music. Lao Zi talk about is music, the disturbed music, bothers our ear. Go deeper. The eyes, the ear, the mouth, external, we call in the Tao teaching, call external three treasures. We see things. We see good things, we see polluted things, all kind of issues. We hear good words, we hear all complaining, yell, nothing, shouting, and we speak good word. We also speak words in the wrong way. But for what? This is called external treasures. Internal treasures, three words. Every day we talk about Shen Qi Jing. Remember the Shen Qi Jing? This is our Tao science universal law. Every day we talk. What we are transforming every day, we are learning Dao De Jing. We are learning healing, transformation for health, relationship, finances. Jing, Qi, Shen. Shen, Qi, Jing, Shen. Three parts. Shen, soul, heart, and mind. Mind over matter, mindfulness means mind can make things happen. Millions of people meditation, now more and more people, especially the business leaders, country leaders, more and more in the business world, they realize meditation. Because when your heart's quiet, you make a right decision. When you are disturbed, you make a wrong decision. And for very influential people, one wrong decision could be big damage. So therefore, this is our Shen. This is energy. And this is matter. This is internal three treasures. Internal. Internal three human treasures. We need to purify our soul, heart, mind, energy, matter. But the external treasures is eyes, ears, and mouth. This is Lao Zi's teaching. Use the five colors, make people blind, disturb others, and the sound, five sound, make people deaf, people affect also, and also tasting. The taste, talk about tasting. In fact, our three external treasures. The treasures also, how can we as a human being? What Lao Zi teaching, you will learn more here. In one sentence, do not need to be bothered by these suppositions. We want internal peace. That is a huge teaching. Think about human's life. If we have internal peace, everything different. Bothers, disturb, anger, emotions, everything go wrong. Health, relationship, finance, everything go wrong. How go back? Therefore, Wu Yin, Wu Yin is a Chinese Jiao Zhi Gong Shang Yu, Gong Shang Jiao Zhi Yu. This is the music, Do Re Mi Fa Sol La Si Do. Music comes from ancient five sound. It's called Wu Yin. In fact, there are many notes, so many notes. and the countless tones. So Lao Zi said, Erlong, literally means ear deaf. The words ear deaf. But here, the deeper meaning is that all kinds of tones disturb the ears and the heart, making the heart not qingjing. I said qingjing is a pure, Chinese word qing is a pure, peaceful, and quiet. Qingjing together, three meaning. Lao Zi wrote another classic for spiritual journey, for spiritual practice called qingjing. Qingjing is a qingjing classic. We shared in early chapter. One sentence, Lao Zi, so deep. Ren neng chang qingjing. I repeat again. This is a review before I shared. Ren neng. Because this is so useful. Every day, can we do this? If we can do this, we are different. We make a difference in our life. Ren, human being. Neng, can. Chang means permanent. Qingjing together. Qingjing, qing, pure. Pure, light. Peaceful. Jing, peaceful. Jing means quiet. So Lao Zi said, if a human being, ren, human being, anyone, can permanent. Oh, we cannot be permanent. We are bothered all the time. But Lao Zi is permanent. It's very important. This is a saint's level who reached Dao, who like Lao Zi, like a Buddha, like a Guan Yin, like a Jesus. Millions of people follow. They have reached a permanent, peaceful, quiet, purity. Ren neng chang qingjing. Tian di. Tian means heaven. Di means Mother Earth. Xi. Xi. Jie. Jie. Gui. 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 Gui means return. If a human being can permanent acquire the peaceful, and acquired peaceful, and also light, and then heaven and the earth all return to you. Therefore, we just know, and qingjing, this is a word try to learn, pure, light, peaceful, and acquired qingjing, every human being needed. It does not matter your spiritual being, not a spiritual being. We are the human being. We need a heart peaceful. We need a brain peaceful. You know, because people talk about monkey mind. When you're upset, qingjing. Okay, go back. So therefore, Lao Zi teaching five tone, and could make ear deaf, is to tell us do not be disturbed by basic noise. Making a heart no qingjing. I said, remember, external treasure, eyes, ear, and mouth, external treasure of human beings, treasures. Internal treasure, shen qi jing. So heart, mind, shen qi, energy, jing, matter. So are we sick or not sick? Are we strong or not strong? Do we have a longevity or not? It all depends on our shen qi jing. Our three external treasure connect with the environment. So therefore, the pollution bothers us. Dao De Jing taught so well. This kind of pollution disturbance make us sick, make us exhaust our original qi. This is a deep wisdom. If you are not a spiritual journey, you may not know this word. You know qi. Millions of people know Chinese qi. Some people call this one qi. Qi is like this. This is the qi. Qi means vital energy, life force. But in the ancient words, there's one writing like this. This is the Qi. Remember I have my calligraphy professor. So why read for this? And he found a dictionary and she explained to me. I studied the ancient Dao. This Qi is original Qi. Original Qi. This is Qi is vital energy, life force. It's a life force. We eat food, there's no food. If we do not eat food, we do not drink water, we do not eat fruit, vitamins, our body do not have the energy. So therefore, this is postnatal energy. This is a original Qi, is an element, prenatal.
P-R-E-N-A-T-A-L.
It's a prenatal Qi. I want everybody to know, in the Dao sacred teaching, I taught my my advanced student, just give you share a little bit of concept. In the traditional Dao, because Dao, this master live hundreds or longer years, it's amazing. It's a Chinese, it's ancient Dao, Dao saints. So therefore, this is a navel. This is Ming Men. Ming means life. Men means gate. So this is a spinal column. So therefore, there is, watch here. There is a Kun Gong. You know, this is Yi Jing. Many people see that. This is Mother Earth's mother. This is heaven and heaven the father. So this is Yin, three Yin, three Yang. So therefore, here is called Kun. Q-U-N, Kun. This is Kun. Kun, there is a... this is, everybody know our candle. You burn a candle, to burn off. You get a bottle, put the oil, the little cotton, the whole, so this is like a life oil lamp between navel and the back. This is such a top secret. So therefore, traditional Dao taught me, it represents 100 years. If the person you are 80 years old, watch. Like this. If you are 50 years old, the secret wisdom, watch. If this one, the oil lamp gone, heart stop beating. So therefore, people die in 50 years old. People could die a newborn baby in mother's womb. A newborn baby, some bacterial virus exhaust this. Newborn baby die. Therefore, in traditional Dao, there's a sacred human being temple. It's called Kun Gong. Gong is a sacred temple. Kun Gong is a true life force. You know, I talk about Shen Qi Jing, the Qi, this Qi, original Qi is here. Father's sperm, mother's egg. This is ancient secret. When you join together, the Dao. Dao is ultimate source. Everybody's equal. Dao loves everybody. They give you Yuan Shen. Shen, remember Shen, we just learned Shen, soul, heart, mind, Shen. Yuan, Yuan means original. Original soul. Yuan Shen creates Yuan Qi. Yuan Qi, in fact, Yuan Qi the best way is write by this way. This is Yuan Qi. Original Qi. This is Yuan Qi. And Yuan Jing. Yuan Jing. Jing means matter, right? Jing means matter. Qi means energy. Qi means energy. So Yuan Shen, Yuan Shen, Yuan Qi, Yuan Jing. Yuan Shen create Yuan Qi and Yuan Jing. But Jing Qi Shen, original Jing Qi Shen, come down for newborn baby, stay 100 years. So therefore, normal physical exercise, even normal meditation, you won't fulfill this. If you are 50 years old, you are 50 years. If you become 80 years old, some major sickness. That, for example, I have a psychology a student. Remotely Toronto, and Bill interview in Bill's book. Bill wrote the book for me. Bill interviewed her. She's psychology. She has a white advanced spiritual eye. Her oil lamp 1 to 2% left. She lied on the bed, use oxygen here, lower parts bleeding, energy depleted. She knew she's going to transition. I was in Germany with Francisco. I connect with the source. I offer the spiritual blessing. And I ask heaven, because I'm a unique servant, and heaven, the Dao, fulfill. Fulfill, and from the side also. Then what happened? In very short time, I fulfill here. Then fulfill much higher than her life come back. So therefore, this is not only theory. I have used this because why I see this today, because our eye, light color. Our ear, noise, our tasting, so much. It's external disturbance. Finally, we exhausted every day. We forgot the meditation, see inside the peaceful, no qing jing xin. We are bothered. Therefore, what happened? We are exhausting our Zait Kun Gong is original Shen Qi Jing. For example, how do I know how good you are? It does not matter you tell me 50 years old, you're 70 years old, you're 30 years old, my third eye, or I can just directly know how many percent of your Kun Gong. That's the key. That's the called true life force. I do meditation. Remember, after I taught why in the future, we plan. Then when I have 1,000 students and plus new people after this teaching, so I will have 1 or 2 days workshop. Bill will be with us, letting me summarize. It's now try to explain the Dao De Jing, but when you study with me, I will teach you how do you fulfill here. That's the key. You want to live a long life, you want to be younger. That's the secret. It's very hard to learn. Dao De Jing is very hard to explain, but these kind of practical techniques more difficult. They do not deliver. This keep in a very few masters, consciousness. Very, because in China they only deliver one master, they only deliver to one lineage holder. This kind of major sense they do not deliver. But I just try to serve. Okay, that's the only point. I have learned from all of that. Thank you. Because my son teacher, the whole life only delivered to me. This is their way. I honor for that. 好，无味令人口爽. You can see this is a traditional Chinese medicine. See the suan, the first line. Suan, sour, ku, bitter, herbs, gan, sugar. Sweet, xin, spicy, and xian, is salty. I went to India, their food is very spicy. Okay, this their way, we honor. So therefore, wu wei means five flavor, which is five flavor. Wu wei ling ren kou shuang, the five flavor can make our mouth unable to taste. If your mouth has a salt, sour, bitter, you know, spicy, salty, sweet. If you take too much, all kinds of taste, some people already have issue. They lost taste. You know, some people sickness, they cannot taste anything. No matter what put the mouth, the same. So the Lao Zi teaching, if too much taste, we could lose ability to taste. What Lao Zi meaning? Continue, learn this. These first three sentences of chapter, 无色令人目盲, five color make people blind, our eye was bothered. And 五音令人耳聋, five sound tone could make us deaf, make us too much bothers for our ear, especially for heart. Then 五味令人口爽, the five taste could make you lose the taste. This is a reality. What the Lao Zi telling us now? The first three sentences of chapter 12, chapter 12, teach one of the deepest wisdom, the biggest enemy is yourself. Wow, Master Sha, what does it mean that the biggest enemy is yourself? You know, this try to say so much, try to and hear so much. Some people, you know, complaining, you know, on the internet, how many complaining? Oh, I love to see that. People may not realize, you know, there's a spiritual father, and in the Buddhist teaching, there are many. I honor all the teachings. There's millions of billions of people listen to this grandmaster, whatever they call. He said open to the public, I never read a newspaper. Wow, shock. I never listen to radio. I never watch TV. This already not a normal people to do this because he's a spiritual father. But when they interview him, people are shocked. He did not see the newspaper, you know, read TV and listen to radio. No, I don't want it. You know, he just every day, qing jing xin. Then I watched his TV interview. You will be shocked. Then the interviews, you know, who said, okay, now, and the country has a big water. How do you explain? He said, big water. People's heart has a greed, G-R-R-E-D, greed, greedy, human heart greedy, nature respond, flood water. Tian, ancient, ever since ancient wisdom, Tian, heaven, Tian is heaven, nature, Tian, Ren is a human being, Gan Yin is respond, respond each other, interrelate each other. When human has a greedy, then natural water. So what does it mean for that? If any part of the world has a bigger water, we feel so sad, we do not want it. That means in that area, maybe this life, maybe past life, because the reason cannot only see this life, expand it. In that area, past life, and in this life, humans greedy heart, not one person, it's just a general condition, cause that water. Why that water disaster not happen in other city or other country? Why water disaster happen there? Fire. So they interview him. He does not watch TV, newspaper, magazine, but that kind of people's most intelligent person. People say, how about the fire here? He said, the fire, people's anger cause natural disaster fire. So therefore, 天人感应, go back again. what Lao Zi said here, this deep wisdom. Okay, so many color, so many tone, so many taste. It's just example. So many pollutions, spiritual pollution, so many disturbance. This disturbance, if you open yourself through your eyes, through your ear, through your mouth, then huala 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 come to you. What happened? People are sick, exhaust your energy, yuan qi. You shorten your life, sick. You reduce your life, many blockages for life because this you allow the permission coming. Biggest enemy is yourself. Close again, light wall, cover you. Nothing bothers me. That's a spiritual journey. You can see everybody think about in the society. Some are very successful, a very good country leader, businessman, some, you know, stars, some of them, all kind of people, all wrong people. If you very calm, very peaceful, do not bother by outside, biggest enemy is yourself. You allow the stuff bother you. I give example. Then one grandmaster taught the Dao De Jing, and he's a major profession. He gave one story I remember very clear when I listened to his insight. He said one time, this speaker has a friend. Then they are both join, a meeting. For example, this is the speaker. He said, I'm the speaker. This is my friend. He's listening. One speaker talking here. But the two of them, between my friend and this one, they just bothers, upsetting, argue all the time. So, and the speaker said, I'm here, and my friends listen. This man speaking. They have issues. This man at the beginning, ready to blah, 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 ready to try to say better words. This man. Listen there. I put the hand here. Listen. No angry, no emotions. This speaker said, I was so impressed. I know this person is say bad words about him. Then he asked his friend, how are you? You know what this man said? I do not know what he's talking. Exactly, no. This man tried to see bothers him. He said, I do not know he's talking. He's not talking about me. He knows exactly he's bother him. But he nothing responded. What I said, give you a light wall. I made your heart a peace. This is so practical. You open yourself, you allow the pollution bothers you. That's his enemy. You are the enemy yourself. If you close, nobody bother you. That's Lao Zi wisdom. Go back again. Will you allow all kinds of colors to dazzle your eyes? All kinds of tones to disturb your ears? And all kinds of taste to make you lose the ability to taste? Therefore, Lao Zi's true teaching is do not see all kind of color. Do not hear all kinds of tones, and do not taste all kinds of flavors. I share this Buddhist master. He taught by himself. I didn't make a story. He said, I do not read newspaper. I do not listen to radio. I see the magazine. I do not see the movie. But the people interview him, he has such a highest wisdom to understand this great connect with the flood, water, the anger related with fire. If something happened in different city, that area, past life, this life, people are that kind of issues. And the great anger caused the water and caused the fire. That's a tianren, nature and a human being are responding. Lao Zi tell us, in the Tao teaching, I teach everybody, move wang shi. At the end, I said, do not say polluted things. 而不妄听, do not hear polluted words. And 口不妄言, do not speak polluted words, unpleasant words. Here, do not taste too much. Basically, the whole idea, the biggest enemy is yourself. You allow this disturbance come to your life. This is very practical. If you hear this hour of my teaching, you okay. From now on, some people are so negative, I will close the door. You have to, because the negativity will affect your thought, that you make a wrong decision. That's not good at all. 吃力,吃疼甜烈,令人心发狂. You know, remember, Bill mission. I totally agree with Bill. Lao Zi has a meaning. I didn't write it here. If you are the hunter, at the ancient time, now, if you are a hunter, it's your job. You know, that's your job, correct? Everybody, watch. The chef. chef, when they're cooking, you know, the fresh fish, the shrimp, people honor 1 pound, to the water. In the spiritual realm, we may have a chef, we may have people, your family member, loved ones, chef. I do not see any bad words. Just I want everybody to know spiritual teaching. You know, they said no more killing, but it's your job. You know, I tell you the smart way of some chef. This is true. When he cut the fish, when he boiling the free shrimp for the water, what do you say? Oh, this is my job, forgive me. They didn't see that. You know, very smart spiritual being. You do it, you do not do it, it's your choice. This chef, when they kill the animals, they said, sorry, it's my job, people order. I'm not willing to do this. Okay, that's it. And you figure out what I'm talking. But here, 池藤田烈 is this nobleman, you know, emperor, the big man. They lock a forest area. Like, okay, Sunday for fun. Okay, for fun. But they go there, bam, the rabbit, the deer, they kill. Their feelings are different. I want to explain to Bill and everybody. Normal hunter is your business. You're making for life. Like this chef, they have to say something because this is the killing. In the spiritual teaching, if you already listen, already let it go. Spiritual teaching avoids any killing. So therefore, but hunter is different. But this kind of a nobleman does not matter from China, other countries. We know that in history. And they shoot a deer, they shoot a rabbit, whatever. They are ha 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 ha. They use killing as a pleasure. That's a lot of teaching. Noble would raise the horse's foot and hand for the pleasure of the chasing and the killing. That's a different hunter for job, for living. But these people, I have power, I have people, I have a team, let me kill. That's a total different. Their heart condition and the consciousness are not correct. You know what I share with you? When they kill the animals, they are very happy, joyful, fun. Have you not felt that to connect with these kind of people is dangerous? Thank you. Okay, think about yourself. Horse racing and hunting can make our heart to go crazy. 池藤田烈,令人是看, horse racing and hunting, 令人 is make human being, can make our heart. 心 is heart, 发狂, crazy. When you hunting, then people, you know, when people dance, crazy over some, you know, emotions. When you're dancing, some special pleasure, you forgot yourself. That's a human being issues. So therefore, Lao Zi used this hunting, you killing as a pleasure. Then Lao Zi said, go crazy. That make this kind of can make us people make our heart go crazy. In today's society, everybody think about to crazily expect something, cause one to lose rationality. So therefore, for example, some people, I want something. I really want this money. I want this job. I want this career. I want to do something. Maybe it's not a proper. I want it. I want to do it. You forgot. Correct, not correct. That is Lao Zi teaching. In today's society, you expect so much. What do you expect? But in one word, you expect material. You want the money, you want the property, you want the success. You are searching externally. You forgot to go inside. Why Lao Zi Dao De Jing is so powerful? Millions and millions and billions of people, country leaders, scientists, because Lao Zi teach you do not have too much desire here, simple life. But the key is to go inside to purify your heart, to uplift your soul. If you are truly spiritual being, you may understand the support. If you're not, you know, some people say, oh, Master Sha, do not talk about this. I need some more money, more energy, a better life. Nothing wrong. We need a good life. But are you going to expect so many things? We may not get it. Are you going to be peaceful, happy? Therefore, 知足常乐, Chinese meaning, 知足常乐 means I feel enough. If I feel enough, I'm always happy. I compare with there's a millionaire, billionaire, some people, we are far from them. But we compare with the beggar, we are much better. 知足, I feel enough. Then you all, this is such a philosophy, 知足. 足 means enough. When I feel enough, 知足, okay, I'm not a millionaire, billionaires, whatever, but I'm comfortable. 长乐, you know, 长 is a very common word in Chinese philosophy. It's a permanent. 乐 means happiness. 长乐, 知足常乐, which means it teaches no more greedy, simple life, happy life is good. Go back again. Therefore, when a person needs to dissolute life, that one has a great difficulty to control himself and his life. Do not have a dissolute life. You expect something too much. Like now everyone in society, some people want something too much. They know that's not good. They just jump in. You lost their mind, lost their heart. They just do it and they made mistakes. At the worst case, they go to jail. We know that. Then we have to know really control our heart. 难得之祸. Before I taught in chapter 3, 不贵难得之祸. Do not honor rare things, stone, gold, some special stone. Rare goods can make us go into the wrong direction. This is a diamond. Oh, this is not 100,000, could it be millions? This is big money. Greedy intention. So see here, do not treasure rare and valuable goods. If others think some goods are fantastic, the right attitude is not to be affected. Okay, this is a multi-million dollar diamond. Wonderful. Okay, nothing related with me. Good. Okay, this is something. Whoa, such a thing. Do not criticize or comment. Okay, you have congratulations. Okay, nothing bothers my heart. Just let it go. Easy to say, difficult to do. That's a spiritual training, spiritual progress. All kinds of precious metals, gold, silver, and the gems, rare birds, some special rare birds, expensive, and more are considered wealth. Or they have special stone, special treasure. But what? These wares become a symbol of desire and the status and the position. I am wealthy. You can see I have how many stone, how many deposit, how many some things treasure, rare goods, and whatever that we call metals, stones. It's become a symbol of a desire. I'm so rich. I have good status, good positions. For example, I know Bill love golf. Golf is such a sport. Bill enjoy that. Wonderful. But listen, there are kind of people, not only in China, worldwide. They are not interesting enough for the golf. I love golf, nothing wrong. I do not play, but I just honor everybody. I just deliver the wisdom. Some people, they're really not interested for golf. But it's, the golf is a wealthy person, a successful person to golf. I'm going to join with them. I can afford the fee, the membership. Some membership fee could be so expensive. I can afford that's not your reality. You're not interested in the golf, but for that, name, I'm a special man, I can join this group. I'm not a criticize anybody. What I want to see is some people is too much for the superficial things, for the name, for the fame, for the name, for I'm special, too much all the side expectation. Lao Zi teach you, do not honor these special, rare, special goods. Because 令人行妨, they can make you go to wrong decision. Do from your heart. It's not to do for any purpose. I use a golf as an example, but I honor any people. Just everybody think about it. There's all kinds of people. We know something is right, something we learn the wisdom. It's not correct. 是以圣人, 为父不为母. That is Lao Zi chapter 12, the key. 圣人 is saints, connect with Dao, align with Dao. Saints expect to have enough food, but do not focus on what they see. 福, because I say 福, 圣人, 是以圣人, 为福, F-U. 福 means belly, abdomen. That 目 is eyes. This is very deep. Lao Zi used two words, 福 and 目. Lao Zi teaches that one's eyes can enslave one's heart. One's eyes can enslave one's heart. Mind and body. When the eyes see, one could be led to do. Because when you see something, okay, I think it's good. I want to do this. One could develop desires. When you see something, great attachment, distinction, and more. For example, when your eyes see something that you do not have, or you see something very rare and special, you could have desires for that sense. Therefore, our eyes can create lots of negativities. Lao Zi teaches to pay attention to your stomach and not to pay attention to your eyes. What do you see? If you pay attention to your stomach, you are the owner of your stomach. I eat well, eat proper, with a nutrient, proper, not eat too much, not eat junk food. This we all know that knowledge. So Lao Zi said, if we pay attention to our stomach, eat properly, you are the owner of your stomach. Okay, I own myself, I'm the owner, I eat properly, I take care of my health and your body. If eyes make you go, oh God, this is, I never see that, wow, this is powerful, oh, I want this, I can do this, so your eyes was attracted. Your eyes, if your eyes makes you go to the wrong direction, then your eyes own you. What mean? You become a slave of your eyes. Remember, that's why Lao Zi said, pay attention to belly, do not pay attention to eyes. Means you do not be disturbed by this, what you see. They attract you. You are the slave of the eyes. Everybody think about society. We are not a slave of the things. People hold the phone every day, morning, night, even a restaurant, in the family. Oh, just watch people eating. I'm not talking, I'm focused here. Slave of phone. Slave of a computer. There's a human issue. Too much. Our eye is living. Living. Our eyes alive. This is a computer. You see, you watch. This computer is you just stay there. When you just watch, what happened later? People, eyes affected, nighttime, sit down here, watch for hours. Then I get hurt, get a sickness. Later could be very serious. People can be blind. Then see, your eyes can be blind. the phone still exists. Eyes cannot handle anymore. What is the teaching here? Lao Zi, 无色令人目盲, 无音令人耳聋, and 无味令人口爽, for ear, for eyes, ear, for mouth. This just tell us, stop external, do not like pollutions affect you, then go inside for 清净心, then your life is different. We are too much bothered by these pollutions, not the world, chaos. I think I cannot finish already. I have little left. I don't want to force more. Bill, come back next week. Continue. Love you. Thank you. No, cannot hear you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Master Sha. Really profound teachings today. The enemy is you. It's our own desires, our own needs, our attachment to our ego. We want to be famous. We want to be super wealthy. We want to show off. These are the things that are going to get us in trouble. Don't be a slave to your computer. Don't be a slave to your smartphone. Balance, balance, balance. That's the secret of a happy life, according to Lao Zi. Don't allow others to influence your true desires. Focus on health. Eat the stomach, not the eyes. What you need when we say stomach, your nutrients, how you're going to fortify your body, take care of your body. And yes, you can splurge. I'm terrible at it. I splurge at least once a week. I go out and overeat and overdo. But normally I do, thanks to my wonderful wife, Gail, follow normal, a lot of salads, healthy foods. We need to take care of ourselves. But we don't need all these accoutrements. We don't need to have, mega mansions, our own private jets. I have friends who have all these things. Some of them are happy, some of them not. It's really a question of balance. So there's much wisdom in this chapter, more to come. We didn't get more than about halfway through the chapter. We'll finish it up again next Monday. I don't know if Vanessa is here today. I don't think she is. So I'm going to do the promotions of what's coming next this week so that you can add it. Oh, Vanessa is here. Okay, wonderful. Then I'm just going to turn it over to Vanessa, and she's going to let you know about some amazing events that are going to happen this week and on the weekend. And we will continue with chapter 12 next Monday. I hope everyone has a wonderful week, and take a little extra time and go within, particularly at this moment on our planet. Don't be overwhelmed by all the bad news that is around us. Go within. Thank you. And here's Vanessa.
Thank you so much, Bill. And thank you, Dr. and Master Sha, for an amazing session once again. I'm just going to take a quick moment to read a little of the comments as they've been coming through. It's really profound to have Dr. and Master Sha share these teachings. Ulrich says, Dear Master Sha, I'm very grateful for the deep teachings today. Thank you, thank you, thank you for sharing your wisdom. Another amazing session, life-changing and spiritual journey accelerating, incredibly uplifting. We are all so blessed. Brigitte says, I could have listened to you for hours, beloved Master Sha. This was so wise and interesting. Thank you from my heart for today's teachings, such profound wisdom. And thank you, dear Bill, for hosting today's live show. We love Bill. Thank you, Bill, for making time every Monday at 2 p.m. You can find us here on Facebook. If this is your first time listening or learning from Dr. and Master Sha, you can go to Dr. and Master Sha on Facebook, click follow, click like. You will see the 11 chapters before this, and you can take notes and start beginning your studies with Dr. Sha. I've been studying with Master Sha for almost 6 years now, and I can tell you it only gets better with time. The more that you submerse yourself into these teachings and really begin to embody the teachings, it's one thing to listen and to hear and to learn from our mind. It's another thing to put this into practice. And that's why you're invited. This Wednesday, Dao Song Healing Hour with Dr. and Master Sha is happening at noon. It's a 1 hour midweek, midday break to rejuvenate you and really align you to the Dao frequency, the Dao Song as sung through Dr. and Master Sha. Roberta Flack has been quoted as saying that listening to Dr. and Master Sha sing is as if listening to the source sing, listening to God sing. It's very, very powerful. Of course, if you are more into the weekend vibe and you have a very busy work week, not a problem. Every single Saturday from 12:30 p.m. Eastern time, that's 12:30 p.m. Eastern time to 2:30 p.m., you will have the opportunity as a first-time participant to come as our guest. Come for free. It's completely on us. We just want you to be in the field, be with Master Sha, receive these high-level teaching wisdom, and experience the power of the Dao calligraphy healing field. Dao calligraphy is a revolutionary, cutting-edge healing technology that is changing the world. And you really have to experience it for yourself to know if it works. So if it is your first time, click on the link, join us. It's absolutely free your first time. Invite a friend. Get a blanket because you're going to lie down and relax. Master Sha teaches. He shares Dao song, and then you actually get to lay down and receive a remote healing blessing from the Dao calligraphy healing field. This is a one-of-a-kind, unique experience. I've had meditators and yogis alike say, whoa, what was that? That was absolutely incredible, and they keep coming back. So you're going to want to check that out. And finally, Sundays, I think, is for the student in us. If you really want to go deeper into the self-healing practices that have transformed hundreds of thousands of people's lives around the world, then you want to join Sunday's Dao Ancient Secrets of All Life. This is also from 12:30 to 2:30 and is more focused on the teaching and simple, easy practices that you can start to use to self-heal, rejuvenate, and create a long and healthy life. This is happening Sundays at 12:30. The team is putting the link into the chat. I have so much to look forward to in this coming week. Master Sha and Bill are here every single Monday at 2 p.m. And finally, last but not least, I'm so stoked about announcing this incredible opportunity to be with Master Sha. It's on July 16th. So if you haven't heard already, you might have heard now, we have an event called Tapping the Source. So if you're watching and you're not so much into like the Dao De Jing, or you're kind of just opening up to this, but you want to understand the science behind what Master Sha is teaching and bringing to the world, you are not going to want to miss Tapping the Source, July 16th, a science and spirituality summit unlike anything that's ever been brought to Earth before. It's with Deepak Chopra, Dr. Irvin Laszlo, Dr. Rulin Xu, who's the co-author to Tao Science with Dr. and Master Sha, a revolutionary book. This is happening on July 16th. 100% of the proceeds are going to the various charities aligned with the speakers, the Love, Peace, Harmony Foundation, the Chopra Foundation, and of course, Irvin Laszlo, who's a two-time Nobel Peace Prize nominee, has his own foundation, the Laszlo Institute of New Paradigm Research. All of these charities will benefit from your participation in the conversation that is changing the world, where science and spirituality meet as one. Bill will be hosting, of course, so you'll have a familiar face to say hi to. And we are very much looking forward to spreading the news about this incredible event. Please share with your friends, invite friends. This is going to be unbelievable. I cannot wait. I've already reserved my ticket. I'm ready to go, and I cannot wait to see you there. Until next time, take care, be well, and of course, we will see you inside the Tao Calligraphy Healing Field and back here next week. Bye for now.